Hey y'all, what is poppin'? It's Till Sheree, and I'm back again with another freaking video. Cause I'm a boss. So you guys already know we got Jeremiah in the mother freaking building.
What's up?
Special guest.
Anyways, so this video we're going to be talking about red flags, not green flags.
Red mother freaking flags.
And y'all, we just about to get right into
okay.
It. So the first red flag we're going to talk about is I don't like talking to somebody who's like late. Like I used to deal with this boy, like his timing, like the timing
that
was never
bad.
Right for him. Like every time we're supposed to meet up, like he's late.
That's a red flag.
And then like it'd be like shit, like sometimes I'd be feeling bad because like situations do happen, but if you that type of nigga that like every time like we're supposed to hang out you're always late, that shit turns me off.
Yeah, not only that, but it's not a good sign when somebody's always late, because when you really care, when you really like somebody anyway, you're gonna be on time.
I mean, that's true. He was honest about certain situations.
Yeah.
But I just don't like that.
Got stuff
I don't like that because I'm an on time person. Like, I'll at least try to do my best.
Yeah, but if you always got stuff coming up too, then maybe you're not really in the position where you need to be seeing somebody like that. If you always got stuff coming up when.
You're right.
You made plans to chill with me and you always got something come up at the last minute. I don't know if you need to be seeing me then.
Right. Real talk. Okay, next, go.
Red flag for me is when somebody has a kid, and that sounds so messed up, but hear me out. Somebody has a kid, it's almost selfish to think this way, but it's like, if you don't have a kid, you're not going to the situation with the kid. It's like, you're going into the situation just wanting a relationship, and it's like, you just kind of in the place where you want to focus on you and that person, right?
Yeah.
But that person is going to be, you know, you're going to be basically sharing attention with their kid, which, you know, is perfectly normal because their child is going to come before anything, of course.
Right.
But at the same time, it's like someone that doesn't have a kid, you may not want to deal with that type of situation.
Yeah, but there's people who don't want kids.
Yeah.
And having a kid, bringing that to the table is a plus to them.
What do you mean? Like, if they all, the person already has a kid?
Don't have kids, but you have a kid. But they don't want any.
So how is that a plus?
Because you have a child and they don't want to have a kid.
Oh, so they're just happy that you already got your kid.
Yeah.
And
being like a family just like that.
Well, one day I want kids, but I don't know, like.
it's like to me, like, I just feel like it depends. Like, if you truly love somebody, you're going to put up with all the garbage that they
yeah,
bring.
Absolutely.
And I wouldn't say kids are garbage, so let me chillax, but it just really depends, I feel like.
It does. It depends on what you're willing to deal with at that moment.
Exactly. And where you at in life. Like, right now, no, I'm not dealing with you and you got a kid. Not right now.
Right. Right.
But if I was probably in my 30s, maybe, or I can, like, see why.
Yeah. A red flag of mine, another one, I had, like, double. Another red flag that I have is if you first start talking to somebody and they got a lot of followers in common with you of people that you've talked to before. That right there.
What does that have to do with anything?
That's a red flag. Yes, that's a red flag. If you just start talking to someone new and then you go on their Instagram and
y'all have mutual friends?
But it's all people that you've talked to before like that.
Okay,
that's a red fucking flag because it's like.
They probably all talking about they're, you.
Exactly. I've talked to people before and I only had one follower in common with them and they was already talking to somebody. They were talking to the one follower that we had in common. And that's always a red flag because that means that everybody is getting around with each other. And I don't like that. Let's not. It's too many people out there for us all to be in the same circle, getting around with the same people. I don't like that.
I don't like that. What do y'all Miami say? So another red flag is, let's just say we on a date and you putting your phone down just like this.
I was thinking about that.
That's a freaking red flag.
Why do you think that's a red flag?
Because I know why. First of all, yeah, like, that's fine if you're talking to multiple people. Like, we're not even at that point, so I wouldn't even get mad or trip. But it's like, there's different scenarios or different ways you could have went about it. As in, like, put your phone in your pocket. There's, like, certain stuff you could do, but, like, you flipping it like that, like, you got a whole girl. Stop fucking playing.
I agree with that. But me, I know personally, me, I've went on dates with people
and I was
talking to multiple. I put my shit down. Well,
that's awkward. Like, put it on your lap.
Well, me, my phone is on do not disturb.
Exactly. When I go
on, if I go on a date and I'm talking to multiple people, I put it on do not disturb. So Tinder and all that type of stuff is not blowing it up. And then the screen come on and then you see it. So, but me, that might be lying. But I mean, shit.
As long as I don't see, like... No, nobody want to talk to you if you're talking to multiple people. Like, at a certain point, like, how old are we?
Yeah. Because I done been with certain people, and it's like, you see their phone, and then you see a notification come up, and you see some shit that they talking to somebody else, and it's like, I don't even want to be here no more.
So. Another red flag for me is, like, you know what, like, notifications on your phone? Like, if you have the Instagram notifications, that's a fucking red flag.
What the heck? What do you mean?
That's a red flag. If you open up your phone, you unlock your phone, and you just have all those notifications, like Instagram and all that shit. Like, that's a red flag for me. Like, you care about social media that much, and you have to keep up who's liking your shit.
Well, wait a minute, because they're gonna get those notifications regardless.
Okay, but at least go on the app. But like, shit.
So they can't help that it's be a lot of people liking their pictures. A lot of people like your pictures.
I mean, that's fine, like I said, but you have to see it every 5 freaking minutes.
I mean,
I don't like that.
A lot of people like
when I go on my inbox, I can see who wrote me. When I go on Instagram, I can see who liked my pictures. I don't need to have no notification for that.
Right. So you must got your notifications turned off.
Like, yeah.
You don't be notified when people like your pictures and stuff?
When, like, I go on the app, like, honestly, like, social media is not that deep for me. Like, I can't live without it. I can't live without a phone.
Oh, you crazy as hell. I can't live without that.
But I can live without it.
I might not like that. Another red flag that I have that I actually has been heavy on my mind is when you are talking to somebody and y'all actually link up and y'all go out with one another. And all they can seem to talk about is their previous relationship. That's a red flag. Number one, that means you're stuck on that person still.
I don't know. It's like a yes and a no, because like when I meet up or go on dates with people, I don't talk about my past relationships at all. Like,
right. Yeah, you shouldn't, because number one, it's rude. Number two, it's like you're gonna make the other person think that you're stuck.
When you do that to me, I feel like you be talking a lot of shit.
Exactly.
That's why I'm not about somebody asking for your location. Is that a red flag for you?
That's definitely a red flag. I've done that in the past, but I'm never going to do that again.
Even if you're dating somebody?
No. Well, number one, we're dating and we don't... The thing is, if we're dating and we don't even live with each other yet, it's not like we've moved in with each other and stuff like that. We're not seriously dating. You're not going to have my location. I just think that that's a form of manipulation.
And I don't think so.
I do.
I don't think so, and I don't think that's a red flag for me. Like, I wouldn't.
It depends on the climate of the relationship.
I would only check it if I know you're freaking lying.
See, that's the thing, though. You shouldn't even be able to. Number one, if you think somebody is lying, you shouldn't be in a freaking relationship with them to start. And then number two, once you start getting to feel like, oh, well, let me open up and see where you at.
Yeah.
We done. So it's like you should be with somebody. You ain't even gotta worry about that. So if you
feel like it doesn't matter, I still want the location.
Nah.
Like if you're at the store and I see you're at the store, I can text you, hey, can you get this?
Okay, well you could just call me on the phone and ask me where I'm at and I'm gonna answer since I'm at the store.
What do you do if like you're talking to somebody and they be like, I'm making plays right now, like I need to know where you're at.
Making plays. Number one, I wouldn't talk to nobody that. What the freak is that even about?
Like,
I wouldn't even talk to somebody that talks like that, because that's freaking ghetto and freaking stupid. What is making plays? So no, first time I feel like I even need to be like, where you at? I don't know if you're where you said you're gonna be. It's done. I'm not playing games like that. I'm only getting older.
And that's true, but these dudes be doing that. That's
doing
the sad
what?
Part. Like,
lying?
Oh, not even lying, but they just be like, oh, I'm making plays. I'm doing this. I'm on the streets, or I'm doing this.
Nigga,
and
you in the streets.
But they don't tell you
streets.
Exactly where they are.
Okay, if you're going to be in the streets, nigga, stay in
I'm
the
running
streets.
Errands type shit. Okay, what errands are you running? Like, let me see the location.
Something, but nah, that ain't got nothing to do with me. Because, Nah. Location doesn't need to be shared. It depends. It just depends. It would be different if it's like we're married.
What about like, I want to like, oh, I can just check your phone. Okay, you're at home. Hey, can you turn the stove off? Can you take the chicken out?
But they would have to be where they said they, if they said.
Hey, I see you at work. Hey, hey, have a nice day at work, babe.
What do you mean?
I'm just saying, like, if I can just check your location and you're at work, I can just say that.
Okay, well, you know what time your man is going to work, so what the freak? You probably told him that already when he was going to work in the morning or something like that. Like, what the freak?
Another red flag. What about going out every weekend? Is that a red flag for you?
Somewhat.
It, for me, yeah.
Somewhat, because the thing is, it's like, it's cool to do that partying crap, like, every once in a while, but if you do it every weekend, number one, I know the type of stuff, like, when everybody's at, like, a club, or everybody's at the wharf, or whatever, drunk, and stuff like that, everybody be pushing up on each other, and people be meeting each other, and types, it's exactly. Like, very much single vibes, when you're exactly. At places like that, and it's like, if we're in a relationship, and you're
still are you gonna doing be that, doing the same thing, like, exactly. What the freak?
And then it's like, every weekend, nah.
That, but it comes with money. Like, you just spending all this money just going out every weekend. True. Just trying to get that fly outfit just to go out every weekend. No. Mm-hmm. We can use that money on traveling. The saving, the bank account.
Something. But spending it all on drinks.
And going out.
Yeah.
And seeing who you're going to buy, what section, what VIP.
Stupid.
Childish. That's serious.
No, for real. That's stupid. Mm-hmm. And it's childish and... That's a huge red flag.
Maybe for me too.
Yep.